Hold on a second. Wait, whoa. Cowardly Prince and the Lion. Thank you. Alright, so where is he? Restraint. There was some restraint.
These humble servants made your Majesty's ailing heart whole again. I pray that our beloved Caulifla's most generous appetite has now abated.
Well, now, we still wish to enjoy the finer things in life, of course. But we have come to feel that a measure of gastronomic restraint may serve to set a good example for our dearest subjects.
Your words are music to the ears of your people. Al Mamun can return to its former magnificence.
Indeed it can, and we are simply itching to return to our labors.
Munificent Caulifla, should these humble servants not be rewarded for their services to Al Mamun?
Indeed they should. Boy, is there something you desire?
Yes, Your Majesty, if it's not too much trouble.
Well, what is it?
We'd like to borrow your ship.
Ship? Floaty wooty. Yes, of course. But of course you may borrow it. It is of little use to us. We will write a letter to the captain, ordering him to help you in any way he can.
You will? Gee. Thank you, Your Majesty.
Tidy, the boat is in the bag.
But why in the world would a dear little thing like you have need of our floaty-woaty? Here.
Letter of passage.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Well, We asked you a question, did we not?
Well,
Go on, man.
Okay. We need to find one of the great sages.
The great sages? Yes, we are aware of them. Abul, we know of them, do we not?
Indeed, most learned Khalifa, but little has been heard of such men since the magical arts fell from favor. Why do you seek the great sages, travelers?
We need their help. We need their power to defeat Shaddar.
What?
Is something wrong?
We are not unamused. But we can see that you speak in earnest. Very well. We will tell you what we know.
You will? I can't wait to hear it.
There were once four great sages. We understand that one of them was defeated by Shaddar.
Mom.
Ah.
But we know of one who did not perish.
You do?
Well.
He lives in the land of Hamlin. A detestable and warlike realm. But he is a handsome young thing. We even keep a picture of him. Abul!
Crikey, sounds like she's got a bit of a crush on the poor lad.
So this is one of the great sages, huh?
That's a clue and a half, that is, Ollie boy. There's Lucky.
Hey, so that portrait.
Now, before you take your leave, we shall teach you some magic to aid you on your journey.
Really? You're a wizard too, Your Majesty.
Well, not a fully fledged wizard, perhaps, but we royals all know a few select spells. King Tom undoubtedly has a trick or two up his own kingly sleeves.
He sure does. He taught me some real neat magic.
How quaint. We hope that you will find our own still neater. Here.
Nature's tongue. Burden.
Oh yeah, man. That's a cracker, that is. A real classic, like.
It's your lucky day, Oliver. Yeah.
May it serve you well. Do be careful out there now, won't you?
Yes, Your Majesty. Thank you, Your Majesty.
Okay. Got the litter. So now we can get a ship. Before that, okay, so here's one. Burden. Will have to a particular item or person. Burden is an incapable versatile spell that simply increases the weight of its target, rendering a creature incapable of moving or attacking, crushing an object or unexpected enemy, or penetrating armor using supernatural heavy pins. The possibilities are endless, and always have a range of options is the mark of a fine wizard. Okay, so it's not like you have a burden, it's just you have extra weight. More weight than normal. And the other one was called... Wait, there it is. Hold on. Nature's Tongue. Converse freely with both flora and fauna. Many are the times when men and women wish that they could converse with the plants and animals which share their lives. Wizards, meanwhile, know that wishing is an ineffective technique and choose instead to cast Nature's Tongue. It allows you to glean from the living world of the kind of information that is quite beyond the reach of an ordinary human. So we can talk to plants and animals. Interesting. Okay. Interesting spells. on. Where could the other two be? How much of the... you know what? Let's just check it, just in case. You never know. Nothing behind here. Anything up here? No. Wait. Yeah, no. Oh, it was right there. Let me see something. Okay. Not here. I figure I'll check. I mean, he's a giant crow man, so it's like, huh? One B. right in here. Where can that third one be hiding? Let's check all the stores. Ooh, we got some new errands. I'll keep that in mind. If I can't find it, I'm gonna have to try again later. Yeah, I can't see it. So I'll probably have to try. Again, and continue on at a different time. My only worry is that if I cross the sea, I don't know how I'm gonna get back, or when I'm gonna get back here, since I'd rather do this now while I'm still in the city. Nothing that looks like a pigeon. I'll probably have to come back later. Do you have any clue? No. Yeah, I'm gonna have to come back. I'm going in circles. I don't see it anywhere. Alright, for now. I'm gonna have to leave it be.
Here goes!
level up.
Here goes!